to me. Protect Detroit. Protect the women in your community. Like your brain right now was thrown. You want, when you get out of here, you trying to release, you trying to get high, you trying to get money, you ain't gotta be that. So we came from all the way from the south to tell you, you ain't gotta be that. You do not have to go that route. What Brian said, I think, is so profound. I ain't never heard him say it. He said that when you sign up to be in the dope game, when you sign up to move work, when you sign up to be in the game, whatever you sign up for, you signing up for all the consequences. I ain't met nobody yet that moved work in the dope game, rose to the top, got him a couple million, and backed out, and they went legit. Everybody say they gonna do it, you know what I'm saying? I got a couple partners like, yeah, I'm gonna do this, boom, 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 then I'm gonna open me up a little wing and fries restaurant. I'm like, bro, you really think you about to just boom in the city, and then all of a sudden you just get success? Like, you gonna get popped, you gonna end up in prison, your brain's gonna be spilt on the pavement, like, you gonna, like, it's gonna happen. It's a trap, and we, listen to the Grace Tour, we fighting that trap.
After speaking, Jeremy donates copies of his book. The book entitled Prodigal to Prodigy is used by facilities to show teens and young adults the keys to overcoming hardships.
I just want to say the message that was delivered by the Grace Tour today was outstanding. It resonated with the youth profoundly, the feedback from them, the engagement of them in the process. And again, the message was outstanding.
The teen travels to an inner city school in Detroit. Brian Thomas, a second year motivational speaker, primarily goes first. The crowd is just warming up, but Brian is still able to engage the students' attention.
Who wants to succeed though? I thought so. Question today, I can't talk over y'all, I'm not gonna do it.
That sounds so familiar.
The question of the day is, which one do you really want?
Jeremy Anderson has spoken to over 100 high schools in the past. A difficult crowd only fuels him to speak more profoundly within each minute.
Ain't nothing lame about education. Are you kidding me? What's lame is you out here doing the same old crimes, the same old stupid stuff. You listen to the same old rappers that only want to take your money, and they not speaking life to you. They speaking death to you, but you listen to them over and over again, then you end up in prison with an orange jumpsuit. That's lame. To not be able to go and use the bathroom when you want to, that's lame. To only be able to eat a certain meal when they let you eat, that's lame. To have gates and bars that cage you, that's lame. Ain't nothing lame about education.
Antoine Knight, a rep from the Detroit City's mayor's office, introduces the Grace Tour.
Will you be somebody who influences somebody else to be successful? See, I understand now that if I'm not who I'm supposed to be, if I don't live my purpose, if I ain't obedient and do what I'm supposed to do, your success could be dependent on that. And somebody else is counting on you the same way. That if you are not who you're supposed to be, if you do not apply yourself, if you don't do the work, you ain't the only one that's gonna fail.
I seen the D. We was driving through yesterday. I saw the abandoned buildings that looked like it got exposed. I see crackheads on the corners. I'm like, yo, that ain't. And you know what's crazy is every crackhead, at one point they was in high school. Don't play with it. You got the opportunity to make whatever decision you wanna make in your life. So I challenge you to watch what you feed your brain. Watch what you feed your brain. Can't nobody make you be successful, and can't nobody make you a failure but yourself. I'll leave you with this here. Once again, if you change your life, you'll change your mind. God bless.
Thinking about the Grace Tour and what has happened since they have been in Detroit, you know, one of the first things I thought about when they said they were coming was, you know, the inspiration they could bring to Detroit kids. And so I remember one of the things that when we went to a juvenile center, I watched as these kids sat there with amazement, like somebody took their time out and spoke with us and inspired us. And you could just tell. And I remember, you know, one of the responses from the kids, like just saying, I really appreciate you coming out. And so this has been really a great opportunity, and this is the hope that Detroit needed. And they poured into these young people here like never before, and it was excited, and I was excited to see it.
Today's speech was when Jeremy talked about finding your own purpose in life and taking charge of the moment, making a conscious decision to be better, to be more, because the power lies in you and you have to embrace it.
And knowledge is the new power. I'm telling you though, is that when you start picking up books and you start reading and you start believing in yourself, I do not care what your situation look like right now, because the caterpillar wasn't a caterpillar forever. You know, you do know that a caterpillar lives its own little slow, grimy, sluggish, nasty, sticky little life. A caterpillar is slow and very vulnerable to where you can easily step on it. That's the life a caterpillar lives. But the caterpillar don't stay a caterpillar. You ain't gotta be slow and sluggish, confined to this little area. You can spread your wings and fly. Like for real, a caterpillar mess around and get stuck to some bark, and that thing starts spinning this silky thread around it that hardens, it turns into like a cocoon, and that caterpillar goes through like an ingestion cycle where it begins to die of itself, take on a higher purpose, and it becomes a butterfly.
But see, there ain't never no right time where you do something wrong and it be right. You know what I mean? Like 2 + 2 is always gonna be 4, right? It ain't never gonna be 5, it ain't never gonna be 6. So anytime you in a situation and you decide to do the wrong thing, hoping to get something right out of it, ain't nothing right about it.
After spending nearly a week in public schools, the crew prepares to speak in churches.
I was in Gainesville, Florida when we started off this tour, and it was a gentleman that stayed in Tent City, which is a camp for homeless individuals, displaced people in society. And he told me, he gave me an IQ for a grace man. And he said, God's redemption at Christ's expense. And it hit me, and I was like, okay. You know, even though I had been on a path of trying to follow God now and committed to it, I understood then what he meant and what Jesus really did for us. And that I can't get myself together. You know, sometimes we'll tell ourselves, well, I'm gonna get myself together and then I'll go to God. It doesn't work that way.
God asked Ezekiel, can these dry bones live? Ezekiel's smart. He like, only you know, God. It was like a trick question. You know what I'm saying? He like, I imagine in my own little brain, I don't know what Sister White said, but I imagine Ezekiel was probably like, all right, so these bones are dead, dry. Well, God can, he said, only you know, God. And what God tell him to do? He said, speak to these bones. Prophesy to the wind. Speak life.
After 2 hospital emergency visits and a week on bed rest, an intense church schedule is relieved by the return of Jillian Monet.
He'll break every chain. His blood breaks all the chains. He'll break every chain. I know he will. Let God break every chain. He'll break every chain. But let me share this with you. It's a secret that the enemy will try to keep from most of us. And that secret is, just because it's dark, it doesn't mean that God is absent. In fact, it doesn't mean that God is punishing you, but it means he is preparing you. That's what that means.
Mm-hmm. So the Grace Tour just rolled through Detroit, hit the DPS schools, Detroit Denby, Detroit East English Village on Wednesday, and I'm gonna tell you, it was amazing to see young people who are in the Detroit public school system, eyes just light up to hear there's hope, that there's a change that can come in their lives, that they're not the people that people told them to be, was amazing this week.
There is
nothing that God can't do. He specializes in working with people like us, as broken, battered, abused, confused. But when you wave the white flag and you say, God, I surrender to you, that's how you get the victory. Any other situation you wave the white flag and you surrender, you're a loser, you giving up. But when you give up to God, you gain the victory. There ain't nothing God can't do. So what we have to do as Christians, we have to say, I have a story. I got a testimony. I got purpose. I got value. I'm a sharer. I'm going to be a relevant Christian. It don't make no sense that people sitting on the steps of the church and they think it's just another building. No, bro, this the house of the Lord. Filled with people. As much as I want to sit still, I can't sit still. God trying to save me through the Grace Tour. So to my young people, don't get it twisted. This is your federation, though you outnumbered with adults. Listen to me, God got value. He got purpose inside you. You ain't got to wait for no church, no federation president, no conference to wait for you to do nothing. You can get busy right now. And what we need is we need the adults to support the young people, pour into the young people, bring out your billfold and give it to the young people. That's how the church grew. Read Acts chapter 2, 42 to 47, it's clear. They gave everything that they had, property, possessions, and gave it. And everybody had the favor of the Lord. Everybody was taken care of. And the word of God says that God added to their number.
We hope that you've enjoyed this episode of The Grace Tour, and we hope that you'll consider partnering with us. You see, The Grace Tour is traveling across the world, sharing the gospel and grace of Jesus Christ. And it's not easy, but it's possible because of the generosity of supporters like you. So if the Spirit leads, we ask that you'll go to the website below, jeremyanderson.org, and click on Partners and become a Grace Partner. People are meeting Jesus, lives are being changed, strongholds are being broken, and you now have a chance to be a part of that. Secondly, you can support us by sharing this video because we believe it's time to make the gospel and grace of Jesus go viral. God bless you, and we hope to see you real soon.